Hello, comic fans. Here's Earl Grey. The books right in front of me have one thing in common, and that is that they all contain comics done by Richard Corben. I want to go through this heap real quick just to give you an overview, some kind of impression about my collection in terms of Richard Corben comics. These two books here are kind of an exception because they don't collect exclusively Corben comics, but from other artists as well. For instance, Hellblazer, the softcover trade number 14 called Good Intentions, starts with a run drawn by Richard Corben, which you can see right from page one. It's typical Corben all over. I mean, John Constantine never had so roundish, soft cheeks, I guess. One of my favorite comics ever drawn by Richard Corben, and one at the same time one of my favorite stories from the Mignola-verse, is The Crooked Man, collected in the Hellboy Library Edition Volume 4. I did a video about it a while before, some months and maybe years before today. And it's quite a remarkable comic, especially because Corben is not one of these artists that tries to mimic the style of Mignola. He does his very own thing and excels in it. Obviously, the colors from Dave Stewart deliver the necessary coherence to it. But now to the real deal, the books that contain 100% Corben goodness. I put them somehow in a chronological order. These are older books from the Volksverlag, published around about in the 70s. These are books from the German Carlsen Verlag, published in the 80s and up to the 90s, I think. But all these stories, almost all of these stories, I think, are available in English as well, but of course in other editions and other formats. What I really like about these German books is that they usually go for the oversize. And just in comparison, yeah, I gave you a comic book, American comic book format. So it's real great to have, for an example, these fantastic pictures of Dan and this huge oversized format where the colors really can shine, pop, and do their thing. Oh, it's great. Every time I open up one of these books, I want to stop my video right now and I have to do this video first. So, yeah, and on the right-hand side, I have hardcovers in English from English publishers, and these are more recent ones, almost exclusively horror books. Starting with the old books, we have here an old anthology, an U-Comic Sonderband, like the other Sonderbände, which I really do love, but they are hastily put together. There's no way around it. And very rushed, and the translation lacks usually, and the lettering is all over the place. And I don't know why you are not told why they choose these stories. It's really a mixed bag of meant to be funny stories and real funny stories and horror stories and sci-fi stories. But it's a glimpse into the work of this amazing artist, and you can't destroy the comics from Richard Corben. His art is just too good. And the importance of this Volksverlag can't be overrated here, because they gave us not only Richard Corben back in the day, but Gilbert Shelton and Robert Crumb and a lot of other artists. But these three, Crumb, Shelton, and Richard Corben, they have a one place in my brain. They are very close to each other in my mind, even though they are very different from each other. But I think it's just because of my exposure way back then to these three great artists. So, I'll put this aside. An anthology that was made a bit nicer is this one here, Die außergewöhnliche Welt des Richard Corben. This is volume 2, The Extraordinary World of Richard Corben. I really wonder and want to have volume 1, but I have not. Damn. And it has a great back cover as well. So yeah, Corben has a thing for big beasts and sharks and dinosaurs in particular, which you can see right here. And I wonder when was the first Jurassic Park movie made? Anyhow, I don't want to go that route. Here we have the Volksverlag version of Mutant World, talked about in my last video. And Rolf, this is a very old story, actually, two story. The Beast from Wolfden is a separate story in the back of the book here. A very early story from Corben, which you can see here. I mean, Corben never struck me as an artist who's lazy by any means or uses his, but he used some shortcuts after that. If he would have done every panel in his old career, in his whole career, like this one here or that one, he would not have been able to put this big amount of comics over the years. But this is a beautiful comic and with amazing colors, and I'm always amazed how good these colors were, but despite of the Volksverlag being really in a very little imprint, and they don't have the big means of a great publisher. Yeah, but this is great. And one of my favorite collected editions of comics ever was and is this book here, Neue Geschichten aus Tausend einer Nacht, written by John Stratt, New Stories from 1001 Night. And this book is just amazing. And I mean, for different, maybe some obvious reasons, this cover was amazed me as a teenage boy and still amazes me today. This book here has to be panelized in the not so too far future. And what is inside is just exactly what the title promises: a new take on these old Scheherazade stories from these Arabian Nights, and with some kind of twists which give Corben a lot of reason to draw these things and monsters that he can do so well. Come on. Yeah. Just a fantastic book. And I would say really Corben on is at its best, definitely. Oh, this book here is not from the Volksverlag, Wick and Blood, The Story of a Boy and His Dog, but by Edition Kunst der Comics. I think this is a Swiss publisher. I'm not sure. I think that's not too important either. Yeah, this comic here has a bit of a different look, mainly because flat colors were used here. This is a very interesting story as well. But now to the Carlson comics. This is a long-lasting series. I think it never was a really commercial success, because you can still find these books that are part-wise almost 30 years old. You can still find them very cheaply, for instance, on eBay. Maybe not so after my video, I don't know, but yeah. I think this has to do, of course, with the publisher Carlsen. Carlsen Verlag was the biggest comic publisher in Germany, and I don't know if they are still today, which doesn't say too much because comics are not a big thing in Germany. But when Carlsen publishes a book, the editions were surely a bit higher than with other comic publishers. So, and here you can see the first two volumes of Dan, which I talked about in my very first Corbin video about Corbin. The House of Stillness, the Mute House. The House of Silence would be a proper translation, sorry. Another Dan story. I always, the very first two volumes of Dan are very close to my heart, so the next ones had it a bit difficult to really wow me. And but they are very recommendable, of course. The Sunken World. This creature here. The Son of the Mutant World, in a way, Mutant World Part 2. I talked about this in the last video. And here we have Pilgor, sort of Dan an amped up Cheesecake Factor, because this guy Pilgor is even a bit stronger than Dan, and the women are a bit more naked than in Dan, and it's everything a bit more for the adults in this book here. And I think there was some kind of print lithographs that you could purchase separately. And there's some kind of failure here. And you don't have to wonder what there's will be cut off. Jeremy's Big Journey is another version of Dan where the main protagonist isn't called Dan, but it's almost a satire on these sci-fi fantasy stories like Dan, but very enjoyable and really fun in a way. Not just in a way, real fun. Children of the Fire. Yeah, here, this is a bit weird stuff. As at some place, the strong suit of Richard Com always was that he experiments a lot with different means and later on with computers and stuff, but not always successful. I want to say 99% of his comics are just amazing, but there's a little fraction, a tiny fraction, where not always everything clicked. The Curse of the Black Diamond, I think this was something like one of these comics that are not his best creations, where he tried some new stuff with computer textures and so on. And way back then it was clearly high-edge stuff, I'm pretty sure of it. Yeah, this is great, of course. Yeah, some panels are just a bit meh, but nevertheless interesting. So here's volume 11 of The Fantastic World of Richard Corben. The Price of the Memory. I'm pretty sure there would be a better translation, but I can't think of it right now. this is one of the panels that I don't know exactly what I should think about it. But yeah, that's Corbin. Very bold, and everything is a bit bigger than life. And somehow that's just exactly what you want with Richard Corbin. Rip in Time. Yeah, this is one of these Jurassic Parkish stories. And I think I've seen it maybe on the Kayfabe channel or Comic Crack. They were published in America as a set of comic book sized issues. So I think this is fine in this case because the art is not so detailed here, but nevertheless I'm glad that I have them in this format here, or this story here. So enough of this stuff. So and it's now to the horror books here. Red God is one of the stories that takes place a bit similar like The Crooked Man out there in the country, and where the natives breed with cousins and breed with their sisters and so on, and they're a bit demented and it's everything a bit weird, and throw in some Lovecraftian creatures in it and you get the plot for this great story here with great colors that I really enjoyed a lot, like everything in this sentence. I enjoy Richard Corbin stuff is somehow not necessary, because it's always the case. Here are two books with adaptations of Edgar Allan Poe stories. This is an older one from 2006 or so. One of these Marvel Max books. Yeah, 2006. It was a three-issue series, mini-series. And all these old stories from Poe. The Raven, for instance, which is pretty interesting. Because in the other book, Spirits of the Dead, that came out in one of the last years, 2014 maybe. Let's see. Yeah. 2014 contains one version of The Raven as well. And these are stories all in color and highly recommended. I mean, if you get some enjoyment out of these Edgar Allan Poe stories, and if you are a bit familiar with these, even if you just have heard the old LP from the Alan Parsons Project, Tales of Mystery and Imagination, this was my introduction to the world of Edgar Allan Poe. And afterwards, I read some Poe stories. If you just have a bit of a feel to for these stories, this is highly recommended. And in the end we have one other version of the Raven. There you go. And this is really interesting if you compare it to the older version. What has he changed after these years, and how he tells now a story? So, Ragemore is a hardcover with a very goofy cover in the first place, but a very typical gothic horror story series. I don't know if it was a 4-issue series or 5 issues. Very enjoyable. Inductee for the Eisner Hall of Fame 2012. 4-issue series. So, and this could be an Edgar Allan Poe adaptation as well, of course. Plays in the same mindset, or with the same mindset. Same with these short stories called collected in Shadows on the Grave. These were issues originally, and in each issue, of course, and in each issue, there were several short stories, which was quite remarkable and unique. Everything created with these black and white shades of his, I think, his daughter Beth Corbin, or is it his wife? I'm not sure, actually. This is a book, when you want to read it from cover to cover, it gets a bit repetitious, but it's a great read if you read just one part of it at a time. And it's very, very, very interesting how he always succeeds in wrapping up a story. On a couple of pages. So, hey, we made it through the stack here, and this is Creepy Presents Richard Corben, the definitive collection of the artist's work from Creepy and Eerie. And that is what it is, done by Dark Horse. And this is one here, you have seen this picture before. And one of the books where I wished that I really went for the German version. There is a German book as well, and in format a lot bigger than this one here, even though this is a bit oversized, but the German version, I don't know if they really can sell this book here to the fans. I hope so for them. But this book here is very recommended, nevertheless, of course, because Mind of the Mars Child. This is a story which was collected in one of the old Volksverlag anthologies that I've shown you before. So, I think I'm never really satisfied with these overview videos, because each of these books deserves to be cherished, to be looked at least for half an hour or so. So we rushed through all of these, but I think it's maybe of some use for you just to see what is and was available over here from Richard Corben. Maybe this is of some interest for you. I hope so. Thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.